It's another red letter day in the world of No Man's Sky as we start what I believe will be called the Fractal Expedition. I say that because today, just a few minutes ago actually, came out the No Man's Sky Fractal update. As you can hear from the background, I've started the game. Let's have a look. Start the new game. Here we go. Oh, it's called Utopia. Okay, I'll have to change the name of the video and all that. No problem. So we got 6 weeks, but this is day one. No idea what to expect. This is gonna be fun. And we're live on YouTube now playing the Utopia Expedition. While we're waiting for this to load, I remind you that I've got live plays from a number of previous expeditions on the same YouTube channel. They may take anywhere from 6 to 8 hours to finish. It varies. I know people can finish them faster. I know people have taken longer. I like to go at my own pace. I don't rush through them because I like to enjoy No Man's Sky, and I'm an explorer. Not a completer, but I do complete these. So here we go. So we're initializing.
Commencing audio system suit initialization.
So this is pretty normal for us.
Life support systems activated. Shield kinetic system online.
So it looks like a nice world so far. So the first priority, of course, is always to survive. So I'll be looking to get my scanners up and running. And to mine some minerals, ferrite dust, make sure I get some sodium in me. And then after that, oxygen is a priority. Alrighty. Let's take a quick look at what I've got. I can create a base right away. That's interesting. Okay. So I always like to change my view. Go. That's my preferred camera view. Let's get some minerals down. And carbon, I don't need that. Beams already down to 39, so let's just make sure I've got a little bit of carbon so I can fuel it as needed. Alright, let's check now. I have a functioning scanner, nothing is broken, what am I worried about? No analysis visor install. Oh. Well, I'm not seeing any nitrogen. Oh, there's some. Alright. There's a source of oxygen. You didn't know, you can mine those grassy pods for oxygen. It's odd that they didn't disappear. That's kind of weird. It's just very manipulative. Carbon in me. Don't seem to have a ship. All right. And this planet doesn't appear to be hazardous either, so that's good news. I say. That wasn't expected. Death by ship combat. I wasn't even in a ship. I think somebody shot me. All right, do I have a grave anywhere? Do I still have my stuff? Well, I've got everything, okay. Still haven't identified any particular need that I have, but I haven't even looked at the expedition yet. That meat will help restore me if I'm injured. Here's some supplies. Some more up here. Here we go. All right. Identify. That's a great big one. So, yeah, that's irresistible. Even has engaged local wildlife. Alright, let's find a cave or someplace safe where I won't be attacked by ships or players. Alright, this is annoying. Okay, I don't even get a chance to. Oh! There's a grave here, that might be helpful. Oh, that was my grave. Okay. All right. So let's get someplace safe where I'm not going to be attacked by a ship, at least not successfully. All right. So I'm underground. Where the hell's my grave? Okay. So, let's see, I can add a few things, like jetpack booster, oxygen, life support upgrade. Not really ready to spend all my oxygen on that. I have a starship somewhere, okay. And bolt caster and shield, but I'll need a wiring loop for that. So I am going to need to get off the planet. Probably. Well, maybe not. Well, with the wiring loop, I certainly will. Alright. Welcome to the Utopia Communal Habitation Project. Select the foundation milestone to pin it as your active mission. And so on. Okay, so let's have a look. Expedition, foundation, establish a base. Okay, so, and I'll get some stuff, including copper, and analysis, visor plans. Okay, so let's have a look overall. Base, craft survival essentials, upload the base to the Utopia project, deploy an exocraft, locate and repair the starship, and travel by exocraft, 2,000 units, register success. That's simple enough. Alright, so a lot of base buildings. Yeah, looks like I'm building bases on 3 planets, 4 planets. So this is interesting. This is the first time where we haven't had to go to expedition waypoints. All right. Well, that's pretty simple. Oh, it crashed. It crashed. No Man's Sky never crashes. Well, let's fire it up again. Is it going to start me over? I wouldn't think so. Maybe I'll have fewer deaths. Alright. Okay, so it's giving me 8 minutes of play time, and I'm not sure how long I've been recording. Okay. Alright then, so, so 2 deaths and a crash. Save now, save often, I guess, eh? So yeah, I mean, I guess the main objective of the expedition when you start is to survive these random attacks. All right, where am I? I'm still in my cave. Okay, good. All right. I'm gonna put it right here. I mean, okay, I might as well. Click Z, create my base. And claim base. Looks like I'm alright. It's night. Still doesn't mean I won't be attacked. Alright, let's build some shelter right off the bat. Floor panel. I like to use floor panels as roofing. Control B makes it a bit easier to build. Alright, now let's get under my roof. Okay. And some more walls. And give myself a door here. Oop. pure ferrite for a door. Let's just give myself an arch, a full arch, not a half arch. And some more walls. Can I do windows? No, I need glass for windows. So I'll do those later. Well, I don't need more walls for now. This is probably good. This will keep me safe enough. Alright, let's claim my expedition prize. I have established a base. It says is deploy a base computer, which I have done. Let's upload it. And let's move my thingy into tunnel edit build C. Okay, let's try again. Z, C, and now move, right or left click, and I'll move this into here. Let's put it right in the corner there. Alright, so I've done that. Shouldn't I be able to claim that? Build more of a base. I don't know. Okay, well, it's kind of dark here still. On that. Actually, let's make some glass and put a roof on that. Okay. Make it a little refiner. Oh, I'm gonna use some metal plating. Can I make metal plating? Maybe. Yep. Okay. Now we'll build my refiner. Okay, we'll make a little bit of glass. I'm just gonna mine some material here. And the reason why I want to make glass is I want it to be easier to see inside my base. You know, at night there's not much I can do, but during the day I can at least get the daylight. Oh, glass is a 1 to 50 ratio now. Hmm. and this is roof. Still awkward, right? To place stuff. There we go. And I'm gonna find my extension now. There we go, I got enough base stuff. Pretty short day here. Okay, and I'll just leave that open for now. Okay, so let's collect that. We saw that expedition thing come up. So collect reward. Okay. Second refiner. Oh, personal refiner unit. Okay. So that's handy. Where is it? I don't see it in my inventory. Oh, there it is. So I'll just put that in there. That's handy to have. So I don't need this anymore, but we'll leave it anyways, because it's always good to have an extra refiner. Let's build my analysis visor if I can. What do I need for that? Carbon nanotubes. Okay. See, I'm glad I got all that carbon out, but I don't have enough anymore. Carbon nanotubes, a carbon nanotube. Now I'll make my analysis advisor.
Technology installed.
Okay. And now I was also given a bunch of carbon, or a bunch of copper. So let's start the process of refining that. Oh, what does it need? It needs fuel. Alright, so doing that because I'll need that for chromatic metal to make my bolt caster. Let's check my expedition again. Survival essentials, okay. Oh, I need my bolt caster, okay, so I'm doing that right now. And then upload the base to the Utopia project. I did upload it before, but maybe I need to do it. Upload base. Okay, yep, there we go. I've contributed to the Utopia project. I think I have my copper done now. Do I? Yep, got 100 chromatic metal. That's great. So let's make my bolt caster, multi-tool, bolt caster. Oh, need 3 more carbon nanotubes. I don't think I have enough carbon for that. So You'll notice I'm not venturing beyond my roof. And I'm probably not going to venture much beyond my roof. I learned my lesson quickly. There's starships out there. They don't give you much of a warning. Okay, so I need 3 of these carbon nanotubes. 1... 2... Oops, need more. Ships out there that are gonna kill me. I don't feel like being killed. So, we'll just stay under the shelter of the roof. Does take a bit more. Alright, 1 more carbon nanotube, and I will make my bolt caster. Alright, bolt caster installed. That should qualify me for. Adopt a pet, but oh, but there you go. I guess it was required. And pat it to make it happier. And make sure it's fed. And that's good enough for now. Alright, so let's come back to the expedition. Ground control, let's collect my reward for this. Prepackaged advanced mining laser unit. Excellent. And I can build my geobase. Also excellent. Okay, so let's load up here. Mining laser, make sure it's beside my actual laser. Okay, and I guess that's it for prepackaged things, but I did learn some plans. Alright. Still can't make my shield, can I? Nope. Okay. Come back here. So, prepare supplies for your journey, survival essentials, life support, hazard protection, can only be recharged with life support gel and ion batteries. Okay. So I need some life support gel and ion batteries. All right. Would have built those anyways. So, life support gel requires dihydrogen. Dihydrogen, jelly, and carbon, and the batteries require, well, a cave visit, and also some more knowledge than I have, apparently. Okay. And I need also some projectiles. For my bolt caster, alright. Did that qualify me for this yet? No. I don't know how I'm gonna get ion batteries without the recipe. Oh, but I do have ion batteries already, so I just need the life support gel. So it's a little more carbon and a little more dihydrogen. in there. More than hydrogen. Alright, do I have enough? No, I need another 13 dihydrogen. See if I can see any from here. There's some right around the corner there. Okay, do I risk it? Let's do it this way. Careful, I don't want to wipe out my supply. Right, back under. Feel like a whole Alright, oh, I get some extra. Good, good, good. Alright, and now I can make some gel. Let's see if we can make a second one of these. Yep. Well, need more carbon. How many of these can I make? Oh, okay, I see. All right, we've satisfied that condition. Let's collect our reward. Expedition. Our reward. Powerful mining beam upgrade. Okay, well, I'll take that. And the base teleport module. So some more supplies for that too. Okay. Alright, so let's install my mining beam extra. I'm gonna move this over here. I'll actually boost the scanner. And I'll just put that there. Cluster them to get the maximum benefit. What else did I get? I think that's it for upgrades, right? Yeah. Okay, but I got some plans. Okay. Still don't know how to get to a wiring loom, but might be something on the base here. Oh look, there's a knowledge stone there. Let's see if I can't make a geo bay. Silver, it's gonna be hard to get. Okay, all I need is metal plating for that one. And for a colossus, that would be even better, right? I only need 5 metal plating. And 4 ion batteries, so I am kind of inclined to go for the Nomad. I'm not sure which is faster. The Colossus obviously holds a lot more. Either way, I'm gonna need 5 metal plating, so start mining. never really been an exocraft person, but I tend to prefer wandering around the planets on foot, and I don't know why. Alright, that should let me make my platform. So I'm gonna go with the Nomad because it just feels prudent to save those batteries while I still don't have cobalt. Okay. And now. Yeah, get into my exocraft. There we go. Got some fuel. Okay. Alright, so I should get a reward for that. Yep, here we go. Hermetic seal. Okay. Supreme Exocraft engine upgrade and something else. I missed it. Powerful movement system upgrade. Okay. Let's see. So we'll install that into the motor. And let's put it in the exocraft. We'll install my movement upgrade. Where's my I'll just move this over here so that they're side by side. Alright. Now, let's learn a wee bit of the local language. And I now know that this is a Gek world. And I also want to find my ship, which is that way. Let's get back to the exocraft and let's go to the ship. Bit of a risk jumping out like that, but that definitely would have been a long ship. Like these deposits, high density deposits, so definitely worth the time to if I had a mining beam in the exocraft, I could do it without getting out, but I don't, so I can't. At least I don't think I do. Attack me was part of the game, or just some other player being annoying. I would like to know. Pick up a little carbon here just in case. Eventually I'll do some scanning. I don't want to scan too soon. Because, you know, there's money in scanning. And if I should get... Oh, I've done my 2,000 units by Exocraft. I'll be at my starship shortly. Also, it appears I'm near a base. So I should just get up on the hill here. Here's my starship. Where's that base? Alright, so let's go to the starship first, then we'll check out the base. Or the base, the building. Register my presence here. Also, I'm by a cave. That's very handy. Collect this damaged machinery. And we'll dig the technology module. These are worth a ton of money. Here we go, now I can get into it. Alright. Welcome, Utopia Settler. Welcome to the Utopia Foundation Communal Habitation Project. Cities! Cities? That would be cool. Wow. Okay, disrupted industry. Let's rebuild, renew, restore. Together we can construct a new civilization. Let's acknowledge that. And, okay. So I'll need to make some pure ferrite. Fortunately, I have a refiner. I don't have much. How much pure ferrite do I might be able to just mine it. I have advanced mining lasers now. I know that's not pure ferrite, but it was there, and it's always useful to get to the car. There's a big plant again. Is being a bit dangerous, but I need to find some pure ferrite and it's dark out. A little more ferrite dust. I'll take that for now. More ferrite dust. Alright, I'll just take the ferrite dust that I have right handy. Hydrogen never hurts. More ferrite dust. Alright, let's get back to the ship. Okay, now maybe I have enough ferrite dust to make. How much? I need 50 pure ferrite. That's plenty. Yes. Nice and fast, I like that. Okay, the hydrogen jelly, which I made earlier, remember? I need to make hermetic seal and metal plating. seal with the condensed carbon that I mined on the way, and plating. Oh, I'm going to need to recover the remaining ferrite dust out of my refiner, and now I can make my metal plating. That's kind of weird. Why won't it let me do that? Try to make it in here. Well, that's really weird. Why can't I make... Hermetic seal didn't get made either. Does it have to be outside? Huh. Oh, I can only make things in the confines of my own base. Right. So let's build a base. I don't have enough chromatic metal to build a base. Oh, how annoying is that? So I have to go all the way back to my base. Okay, well, let's see. I know it's critically damaged. Let's see if there's any... Okay, I can collect my reward. Packaged Icarus fuel system unit. Well, I can boost my exocraft engine anyway. Well, that's nice. Companionship complete. Got my reward for that. Defensive systems upgrade. Well, we like that. Inventory slots. Okay, we'll want to do that first. Okay. Let's upload the shield module. And we'll put that here. What else do we have? Prepackaged Icarus. Okay, so I'm going to go into the Exocraft. What else we got? Engine module. Okay. There we go. These are all bundled together. So at least it'll go faster now. Probably burn a lot more fuel, but what can I do about that? Charge. Well, I got a fair amount of fuel. Okay. Yeah, I'm good. Alright. Anything else? No, looks like there's no avoiding it. I have to go back to the base. So, metal plating and a hermetic seal. Right? Yep. Okay, let's do that. It's annoying to have to do, but oops. Into a hole of my own making. Alright, back to the base we go. Actually, there was a building nearby, wasn't there? Let's maybe pick up a little money too now. You don't get much money for those. There's a little bit more money. A little bit more. And there's one more there. Alright. see if we can't find that base now. It wasn't far. It might be out of range. Nope, there it is. That's my base. Now I'm looking for... lost it. It's there somewhere. It's my base. Someone's base. That's this? Yeah, 22 units. No, that's not the one I want. There it is. Alright, let's go to that. It's not the direct line back to... Right, okay, I'll be able to find that again. Base. Can I craft things here? Nope. No, I'll have to be in my Utopia base. Okay. Gather that. Useful base, unfortunately. Just a couple of these little HAB units. And I'm looking, there's always a buried technology module in these things, in these little bases. Also, you might not know this, but anytime you find one of these damaged equipment, you'll find one of those buried technology modules as well. Alright, back to, let's go to the base. That's my base now, right? Okay, so, yeah. I don't recall deploying a navigation marker, though. Let's not just record that I'm here. Keep note of the fact that funny that I ran right smack dab, just going in a straight line to my base, I ran smack dab into one of those holes. Far away. That was sodium nitrate. Nice big deposit of it. Hard to see. Where did it go? There it is. Nice to have that. Hard to make, but easy to work. Well, not hard to make, but... Okay, I'm looking for my base again. Wherever it is. It's getting harder and harder to find things with other people building bases on the planet. not sure the minutes here, minute travel time, the real minutes. It feels like less. So I suppose it would have been better to build my base near my ship, but I didn't know that. Safer. Alright, now let's craft some metal plating. Let's craft hermetic seal. Is there anything else I might need to craft while I'm here? I can't make a wire loom starship. That later. Alright, let's get my back into the exocraft. Oops. Again, falling into a hole of my own making. Alright, where's my ship? Exocraft. Sure, somewhere. There it is. And back to the ship we go. That was kind of annoying. I always just toss the rusted metal. It's not really worth anything. Get Rella. Well, if I were to find the portal, that would be handy. And we'll just gather that damaged carbon here. Back in we go. Gather the sodium, the oxygen there. Some more sodium. Well, I'm right at this cave. I'm gonna gather cobalt and use that to make batteries if I need to. I don't think I even have the recipe for batteries yet. Get into that ship and repair it. Okay.
Technology repaired.
Now, what else is there in the expedition here? Okay, collect reward. Take and repair the ship. Launch fuel. We're almost done the first phase of the expedition. We're almost done this episode. Okay. Ooh, suspicious package. Suspicious launch thruster module. Ooh. And register success on the first planet. How? Please proceed to the next planet. Receive details. I wonder which is the next planet. Well, let's find out. Reach the outpost. Okay, it'll probably tell me where the outpost is. There we go. Faster if you travel by space. Now I can just pulse engine right into it, I think. And there, arriving in a few seconds. Alpha. Where is it? I don't see it. Summon the exocraft. Let's get into the exocraft. It's this way. Normally, like I say, I would walk it. message module. Spaceship, and we'll where's my little call booth? It's so dark I can't see. Here we go, call starship. See, that's why I pick up navigation markers when I can, and I'll just jump in. And I'll jump out and save a restore point. And that's it for episode 1 of the Utopia Expedition. We've completed phase 1. So I gotta go, but I'll see you next time, probably later today, for episode 2. So thanks for being with me.